Today, we're reviewing an app called TeuxDeux, and it is a popular application. It's one that YouTuber Matt Diavella uses as a way to manage his task list. Today, we're going to overview whether it's worth it and whether it's suitable for you and show you around all of the features. So welcome everyone. If you're new here, do subscribe and you can jump over to toolfinder.co if you're interested in more TeuxDeux apps and you're in that process of researching. There's also a guide to TeuxDeux list apps below, which you can download for free. So TeuxDeux is an interesting one, and the best place to start with these sort of applications is the pricing. And the pricing for this one is $4 per month billed monthly. There is an annual plan which saves you about 25%, which makes it come out roughly the same cost as Todoist and TickTick, roughly in between those apps. Now, the premium gives you desktop and iOS and Android versions, and to my knowledge, there's no free version. You do get a free trial, so we're looking at this app as a paid experience. So this right here is what TeuxDeux looks like, and it's quite nice because a lot of people go for these sort of apps because of that weak planner ability, the ability to see a Kanban style structure, but more of a desk pad. This is an experience that people typically go for. So if you're somebody that likes that sort of things and having lists below, you might like an app like this. We've got another review coming out on Tweak, which you can find the link in the description. So this is the design, and it's really, really simple to kick things off. All you do to add a task is literally type it into this system. And it's really nice because you can also add notes on the tasks and some more details and links, as well as subtasks as part of that. So in this case, this here's a subtask, and I can tick that item off, which is quite nice. It gives a simple nature to it without over completing or over adding more detail, which is quite nice. So that's how you go about ticking an item off for a thing. There's also ticking an item off. As you can see, a cat just jumped out of that task, which is a nice, fun addition to this. And that happens, and you can also turn that off inside the settings, which is something you might want to do. Now, what's cool as well is you can negative something, which means it takes it away, and also create subtasks within the list, or subheading, sorry, which is a great way to break a task down or break a list down that you've got. For example, you could put something like afternoon, and that gives you an indication, for example, afternoon, sorry, you could break that down, and it gives you an ability to see some of the afternoon items, for example, task A, and then you can add items below it, which is quite a nice addition. Now, one final thing about this is you can color code it, which is a nice addition. This helps for items to stand out, and you might want to highlight them as well. Now, if you're looking at recurring items, you can create them over here, and this is great for, say, you wanted to do something every 2 days. You can start this on there, and it automatically populates the entire list, a little bit like a calendar event. Now, some of the negatives to this here is that it doesn't actually have a Google Calendar integration or a calendar integration whatsoever, which is a little bit of a painful thing. But down here, they do have a way to break down lists that you're working on. For example, if you did want to plan ahead, for example, next week, you could say task ABC and start planning ahead. Each item can then be given a highlighter, and you can plan and create new lists from here. So if I wanted to create a new list, I can see that that pops up here. But if I wanted to create an entirely new tab, then it can come here and I can make lists broken down on that. Now, why are these lists beneficial? Well, these lists can be dragged into your week ahead, which is a nice way to zoom in on what you need to focus on and grab tasks that are important to you. This especially works well on desktop. Now, the mobile applications, both on iOS and Android, are much more of a viewer experience compared to this more spanned laid out, and they are very nice. They work very well in terms of being easy, but functional, but get the job done, if that makes sense. Now, there are a few things down here. You can turn things into 1, 3, 5, and 7 columns, and there's a dark mode too. You've also got the ability to manage the recurring tasks at any time down here and see any preferences like text spacing, what you want as bullet styles, and when you want to start items on. You can even modify some of the preferences in terms of like background color and things like that. Now, I'm on the free 7-day trial. There is 7 days free, so you can try this out to see whether it's right for you. There's also custom holidays as part of this, which means you can add items to the top, like you could say holiday, and it almost pins at the top here. Now, there's a notification element here if you want to find it, and you can jump ahead to your next week over here. Now, this bottom bar still stays relevant, but you can remove it if you find it more suitable. So who is TeuxDeux best for? Well, TeuxDeux is probably suited for those who like to zoom out plan, those who maybe have desk pads and find themselves trying to organize themselves and want something a lot more basic and simple. It has a good iOS and Android app and works very well here. The pros are that it's going to be great for those experience. The negatives are that you might not be able to get this connected to your calendar, which is a bit of a shame. An addition of a calendar would be incredibly helpful. But all in all, this app is well built, well designed, and easy to use. And for those who are much more visual task management, you'll find this really simple. If you're still struggling to find a TeuxDeux list app, you can jump over to toolfinder.co and explore all of the options. You can get TeuxDeux below if you're interested, and of course, you can explore our guide to TeuxDeux list apps if you're interested. So thanks very much for stopping by, and hope this helped you work out whether TeuxDeux was suitable for you.